sound off, we call it Jay. It's Colin Jay. What's the news? What's the info? Talk to me now. Talk to me, talk to me now.
Christina May Young.
It's Lando Calrissian. Lando Calrissian from from the movie Han Solo. Okay. That's the part that he's going to play that was previously played by Billy Dee Williams. That's his name.
Coke 45.
And if you look at him, that's a good casting. That's good.
So he going to have the Jerry Carroll and everything?
You know what? He may have a little perm. It looks like he got a little good hair. Like he can put some water on it and curl up a little bit. So I'm thinking that he can make it work. He can make it work. So that's going to be a good look. But 2018, a lot of the new fans have to wait for season two of Atlanta until then. But shout out to Donald Glover, no relation to Danny Glover, a.k.a. Childish Gambino,
a.k.a. Lethal Weapon.
Lethal Weapon. Yeah. No relation, no. But good look for him. That's inspiring. That's a good look. Yeah, that's definitely a good look. Yeah, so proud of that, brother. And then also, bravo to Bravo. Did y'all see the episode of Black-ish last night?
Missed it.
Man.
Was it good?
It was epic. I'll say that. I will say that. It was epic. They did an amazing job. And basically what they talked about was the climate of our society post-presidential election.
Okay.
And they were talking about how it's affecting the kids at school. It's almost like they have to go through counseling, and they needed just a moment to reflect, and all of that. And then they were talking about how it is at work and the culture that it's creating, and then some people are afraid to say who they voted for and different things like that. it's a lot of stuff. And then how, something that was supposed to be something to bring us together, it just ended up being divisive, and our country is more separated than it's ever been.
Wow.
Yeah.
You can see it every day. Even on social media, you'll see a lot of people still trying to divide. Yeah, they're still trying to divide.
Yep. That's right. But it's crazy because they did go through all of that. They went through all of the changes, all of the emotionals, ups and downs and everything. But then towards the end of it, they just pulled it all together. And they ended the episode with the Martin Luther King, I Have a Dream speech. Okay.
That was good.
Yeah, that was good. Yeah. But it was a lot of emotional ups and downs and all of that. And then, and at first I was like, okay, what direction are y'all going? What are y'all doing with this? Because it seems like, at this point, we can talk about how everything is negative. We can talk about everything till we're blue in the face.
Right.
But at the end of the day, that's not going to heal anything. That's not going to mend anything. So they did talk about all of those. It was well written. It was very well written. And so good job to Kenya Barris, who's the show's creator. Mm-hmm. He, wrote that episode and everything, writer, producer, creator, all of that good stuff. He did an amazing job. Yeah, that was a real good look because they did go through all of those emotions, everything that we're all feeling, but then they just kind of brought it all together at the end. I was really, really impressed. I didn't want it to end. It was that good.
It's a must see. On demand, must see.
Demand. So if you guys didn't see the episode of Black-ish last night, for sure, go and check it out, without a doubt. Without a doubt. Yeah. So, y'all gotta get up on y'all Black-ish stuff. Okay, but G.I.'s been telling me about Star. Star. Have y'all been seeing, have you seen Star? Have you seen Star? You gotta let us know.
Finally seen it?
And you know what? I haven't. But when I do, we're going to give our review about that. And then we're going to start going into some movie reviews here because I got to give my little two cents about a couple of movies that's been out.
Hey, I'm surprised that Facebook's TV station ain't posted. They always posting everything on Facebook.
I think they have. Star is getting good ratings. Good ratings. It's because it's produced by the same guy that produced Empire.
Mm-hmm.
What's his name? Lee Daniels?
Lee Daniels.
Yeah,
Lee Daniels.
Same guy.
Okay, so what's the basic premise of the show?
It's basically by three girls that form a girl group, two sisters and a friend.
Really?
You know what I'm saying? One of the friends' dad is Lenny Kravitz.
Mm-hmm. So Lenny Kravitz, okay, that's the dad. Where does Queen Latifah come in at?
She's the best friend's mom of the two sisters. The mom passed away a long time ago, and the sisters went through foster homes and stuff.
Okay, and then...
They finally found... They ran away from home. They went looking for Queen Latifah because they still trying to make it. And Queen Latifah and the mom had a singing group too.
Oh really?
So yeah.
Oh, so is there like some conflict between the two of them, or are they good?
Well, she doesn't. Well, with Queen Latifah, she doesn't want them to be singers. You know, because she knows what she's been through.
That's true. That's typically how it is, especially with a lot of those old singers.
But we don't listen.
Uh-huh.
We ain't trying to hear none of that.
So where does, okay, so Naomi Campbell.
Yeah, Naomi Campbell was the mother. Mm-hmm. Lenny Kravitz is his wife.
Really? Naomi Naomi Campbell and Lenny Kravitz are married in the episode. Okay, and then Queen Latifah is like the godmother or something like
that.
Right, right. Get out of here.
Yeah, it's good. It's a must see. It is good.
Okay, so we got to check out. Y'all got to check out
Blackish. They did a good job. They did a really good job. And it's very, very unique. The girls, they can sing.
Really? So they can legitimately sing?
Legitimately sing.
Really? So, so are they like, kind of like, okay, so like
they
the,
are different from any groupers out there. They don't sound like nobody.
So can they like, or can they be put out right now as a group?
Most definitely. Well, actually, some of these songs are on iTunes.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Get out of here.
That's what's up.
Oh, yeah, we for sure got to check them out. We got to check them out. And I know I keep on saying
you know how D-Daniels does it.
He
put them on
out.
iTunes.
Yeah, and then they end up being a number one song and, you know, all of that. That is true.
Same thing. He's doing the same thing with this Stars. It's a good, it's a good
So he's kind of making money double ways, huh?
Oh, he's the man.
He really is. Oh, he is doing a darn thing.
So
somebody's co-signing. Jackie Chapman is saying, you know, Star is good.
Yeah.
So, I got to watch it. Jackie, I'm going to watch it and get my little 2 cents next week for sure. Because, you know, I like giving my little reviews and stuff like that and then just acting out the little parts and stuff. So, y'all got to watch it. You got to keep watching it. And then, you know, Wild Bill, you got to watch it. So, you know, we can
I'm two episodes in, so you got two episodes.
Really? Yeah,
watch.
I'm going
to
catch up.
So, if you haven't seen, you got two episodes you can see right now on demand.
On demand. See, no excuse. That is true.
Fox
on
TV.
Demand.
Fox TV.
I be trying to tune in, but I'm just not no TV person, you know?
Well, you're going to have to become a TV person so we can talk. We got to chop it up.
I know, right?
Uh-huh.
I know, right?
Some Dish Nation.
So you mean I got to sit there and watch Empire?
Okay. Yes, you got to sit and watch Empire. You got to sit and watch Blackish. You got to sit and watch Star, for sure, because we're going to talk about that next.
Without falling asleep.
Without falling asleep, exactly. Okay. That's right.
All right.
So, you can always press pause.
Okay, press pause when I feel like I'm
done.
Yeah,
take a nap and then
come right back to it.
That's right. Okay, so that, you know, again, that was a really impactful episode of Blackish. So I would encourage anyone, you know, for sure watch that. It was really great. And then speaking of Blackish, just to go, you know, and speaking of the presidential debate, you know, today. And we all saw President Obama, you know, saying his final speech, his farewell, you know, to the White House.
I got a question for you.
What?
Did you cry?
I did. I'm going to own it. I cried like a baby. And especially when he gave the tribute to Michelle Obama. Like, I was just like, oh, my God. Because we've never seen love and cohesiveness and togetherness and best friends and, you know, and PDA. You know, they're always touching. And, you know, that was good. That was good. And that spoke to family values.
This is the first time I ever seen a farewell.
Yeah, the farewell because we never paid attention. We never paid attention. That is typically something that's done. That
farewell.
That's
because we wanted all the president to get out of there.
You know, but this one was really, really emotional.
Right?
And
except
then so today, Joe Biden, he did his farewell for the vice presidential farewell was today. Okay. And then so President Obama surprised him today with the Presidential Medal of Freedom.
Wow.
And he cried. I cried. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my God.
It's
a lot of crying in the United States.
Sensitive. Super sensitive. I mean, even when Michelle Obama gave her speech and everything, when she was saying her goodbye, you know, it was like a couple of days before Obama's. I mean, you saw the women behind her. Wasn't a dry eye in the house. And even she got emotional. And I was just losing it when the daughter was sitting there next to her crying. I'm like, oh, my goodness. It's just super emotional. And then just given the state of affairs in our nation now, it just compounded everything. So, goodness. But Joe Biden, oh, yeah, I lost it.
USA, United Sensitive America.
you sat there quiet. It took you a moment to think of that, huh?
Yeah,
you are so silly. But look, so it was cool because, you know, and then first off, part of him coming to tears is President Obama has a way with words, you know, and he has a way of just giving you that tribute that's going to pull at those heartstrings.
You think he was a pimp when he was young?
You know what I mean? It's like that pimp day slick back.
Hey,
a pimp
day
slick back.
Right.
He is
come here,
smooth
baby. Let
with
me tell you something.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, that brother is smooth with it. So I don't want to call the president a pimp or nothing like that, but he's real smooth with it. But, yeah, so, okay, smooth one talk. Of the things that he said. He said he called Biden the best vice president America's ever had.
Mm-hmm.
He also said this also gives the internet one last opportunity to talk about our bromance. Because I know y'all have seen all of the memes with Biden and, with President Obama. And yeah, they're always doing something. It seems like they're always up to something. And then Biden is always saying something slick. And then Obama is always like, okay, you know what? Be quiet, Joe. You know, always shushing him or something. So if y'all haven't seen the memes, y'all have to see those. Those are so
Joe
hilarious.
Be ready to attack it.
Yeah, Joe be ready to go get it in. And then Obama's like, you know what? Chill out, Joe. You know? Yeah. So that's real cool. So, you know, it's cool, like, you know, to see them and their bromance and all of that. So that's one of the things that he said. It gives America one last opportunity to talk about our bromance. So,
oh, okay.
Yeah. So it was, that was really sweet. And it was just really emotional. So it's just been a lot of emotional stuff on television. But what's crazy, it's all centered around the most recent, you know, presidential election.
And Odell Beckham was emotional.
Was he emotional?
He was emotional after the game. He punched a hole in the wall.
Oh, he did?
Yes.
As he
so
should.
So it's a lot of emotion going around.
That was a whole other something else. But you know what?
It's all about emotions.
Okay, emotion, you know, leave it to the R&B kids.
I know, right?
Leave it to the R&B kids to represent all his own songs.
Oh, man.
Emotions make you cry sometimes. Okay, look, don't you want me to sing that? But how are you going to reference your own song?
Remix.
I know. For real. Okay, but Odell Beckham, you know what? He need to sit down somewhere. Because how are you going to be sitting on a yacht with Trey Songz and all the homies, which was a little suspect anyway.
Right, you're going to talk about that.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm going to talk about it. Like, for real. You know, you're sitting on a boat with about 100,000 dudes. You know, y'all should be somewhere practicing. You're
with
like
their
one
shirts
of the
off and tight pants.
Shirts off, tight pants, and then one
and
of them.
Timbos.
Exactly, Timbos, and then somebody had on a little a hoodie.
They was making a statement.
Like,
they was just making a statement.
What statement?
Hey.
They was making a statement.
They was
hey.
Making a statement.
They was making a statement, all right, for real.
They know TMZ watching.
No, I'm just saying they should have been, like, focusing on the game, to me. That's just my opinion. That's what they should have been focusing
on.
Well,
that was a week before the
game,
wasn't it?
It was a week before, but still, you got to get your mind right and your grind tight. And what? You know, if they're not going to be on a yacht and just, you know, sipping on Kool-Aid, you know what
I mean?
We're
going to turn up.
Exactly.
So sipping on that bubbly.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So if they're in turn-up mode and, you know, all of that, they should have been focusing on, you know, focusing on the game and just kind of getting everything together and getting their mind right. That's just my opinion. And I think that was the overall consensus for a number of people in New York as well, you know, that they should have been focusing on the game instead of turning up. They got plenty of time to turn up after they win that Super Bowl.
That's true.
They were just too close. Too close.
They had 5 days to relax, though.
Mm-hmm.
See, at least 5 days to relax.
There you go. You one of them homies or something like that. You like just sticking up for him? No, that was not okay. That was not okay. You know, it wasn't.
We're gonna go to Miami and sip on some bubbly.
Yeah. All right.
After y'all take care of business first. You know, after you take care of business first. Okay, so speaking of chopping it up and all of that kind of stuff, we got to talk about the new hookups and stuff that's going on.
We will
talk about that when we come back in just a moment with the sound off. We're back. We're in the place. And Dez in your face.
Come on now.
Boy.
Break it down for me.
Dez is in the building. Yeah, he on that, you know, Dez White with 2 Z's. What's going on, Dez?
Yeah, I'm in this joint.
He's in this joint. Okay, so before we went on break, we spoke about, you know, people hooking up and a little bit of trifling stuff. I want to ask G.I. about that.
What happened?
You know, you're in that R&B game.
What happened?
Okay, so Selena Gomez.
Yeah.
She was seen. I don't want to say they're dating, but it sure looked a little cozy with The Weeknd.
With The Weeknd?
Yeah.
What was they drinking?
You know what? See, there you go. No, but I'm telling you, so they were together.
Okay.
And then they were hugging. She was, you know, holding him from behind and kissing him on the cheek. And it turned around. And then they kissed.
Ooh.
What? Yes. And they were hugged up. They were all kissing, like girly and stuff.
They were kissing.
Thank you.
Stab.
He was just dating Gigi Hadid, you know? And, you know, Taylor Swift's little Mean Girl crew and all of that kind of stuff, right? Uh-huh. And one of the girls in the Mean Girls crew, Gigi Hadid, she was dating, Bella Hadid is in the Mean Girls crew, but he was just dating her sister.
Really?
So that's a little kind of close for comfort. You know what I'm saying?
I do call to know all these people business is what I'm trying to figure out.
She got too much time on her hands.
How do she know these people business?
She knows it. That's what it is.
But you don't think that's a little trifling? When I was telling G.I. about that, he didn't seem real surprised by it. So that's how y'all get down in that little R&B, in the R&B world, in the music world.
You can't tell nobody who to love.
Really?
You know what I'm saying?
Oh,
spoken like a true R&B cat right
there.
You can't tell nobody who to love.
Right? You see how he put that love on there?
He put the reverb in his voice, and all. You can't tell anybody who to love. Okay.
You can't tell nobody who to love.
Love, yeah, baby.
Right.
What was bad for, you was good for somebody else.
Oh, your thing. That's the Pimp Nay Slick back right there. Well, I guess so. I just thought it was a little bit closer.
That's why a lot of people not in love, because they too busy worrying about their other friends.
You're right about that.
Really?
Uh-oh.
Yep. Huh?
Uh-oh.
I think that's kind of trifling. Let's put it in perspective here.
If you was married, it'd be trifling.
Okay.
I put it that way.
Okay, but
there's no ring on nobody's finger.
Okay, so what's the situation with, like, there's no bro code or no, you know what I mean? What's up with that? Break it down.
I think it depends
break
it on it depends on what they've been through.
Really?
It depends on how much they've been through with that person.
But get this. They were dating for a pretty lengthy time, and they just broke up in December. And it's January, and your girl is messing with your dude. Well,
she's starting the New Year right now.
I can't believe I can't believe that y'all are not just don't find this just horrible.
Find that in the Bible. Did I sign it horrible?
This is travesty.
Find that in the Bible. It says something about spouses and stuff like that, but not about girlfriend and boyfriends.
Well.
Girlfriend and boyfriend. You know what? Whatever.
Well.
Maybe I'm a little sensitive. Maybe because I'm a girl. That's kind of trifling.
You want to. You use that one. Go right ahead. We'll get your head out.
We use the girl code, man.
He's just glad that the weekend is with a girl.
Yeah, that was the girl code.
Okay, who created the girl code?
Who created the girl code, but it seems like isn't it a bro code?
Find
like,
that
don't y'all
in.
Have a sticks before find chicks a... bro code?
Show me where that's written
What's
to.
What's up with that?
Show me some proof of where that's written to. The girl code and bro code.
Y'all, you know you heard that before. Sticks before chicks and not put that way.
That's an urban legend.
Sticks before chicks. Listen, I prefer a chicks before sticks.
Why take me a moment? I had to laugh.
I prefer chicks.
Before sticks.
Before sticks. I was like, wait a minute, huh?
No, X the sticks. X that out, period.
Well, okay.
Yeah.
I don't know. I thought it was kind of trife. Yeah. Okay, so the madness that is freaking Chris Brown and Soulja Boy.
Right.
All right, so all of that is taking place and everything. So it is going to be a fight. Now they're saying that it's going to be in Dubai. We got to switch from that. Go from the R&B to the gully. So now we're talking gully, and we're talking about it's going to be in Dubai. They can't do it at MGM Grand because neither of them will pass the drug test.
Wow.
Yeah. So the commission, they're like, nah, it's
fight
not going to
be
here.
In Dubai.
It's going to be in Dubai, and it is still going to be on pay-per-view from what they were saying.
Man, you done lost me on that one.
Yeah. So we're going to see how we're going to see how this unfolds and who's actually going to be promoting it and all of that, because now there's back and forth that Floyd shouldn't even be in it. This is a blood thing. So now they're taking it to the streets for real.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I can't wait
the promoter and the trainer.
I'm telling you, he double dipping. He's double dipping.
The promoter and the trainer.
The promoter, the trainer, the everything. So, yeah, that's going to be a trip to see what happens. But in the interim, yesterday, I guess somebody, you know, we're going to have to figure out, and I know the LAP is trying to figure out what Chris Brown's alibi is, because Soulja Boy was robbed yesterday. Somebody kicked in his front door.
Ooh.
Yeah, $10,000 worth of jewelry.
Let me ask you this question. Is it his front door or is it old buddy's mama front door?
Yeah. Oh, wow. I was thinking that too. They didn't give all those details. Yeah. They didn't give all those details. Because what he's staying in some rapper's, they were staying in some rapper's mama's house in the basement or something like that.
Sean Kingston.
There you go. Staying at his mama's house. So I guess we'll find that out
after. Wasn't there?
Nobody was there. So there were no witnesses. But apparently, they caught whoever it was they may have on the home security system.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so we'll see. Soulja Boy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Soulja Boy. $10,000 in cash and $12,000 worth of jewelry.
But he was in the weight room, though.
He was at the gym. I don't know.
He wasn't waiting when he was shooting at the gym.
Well, okay, we wasn't waiting. And the robber must have knew that because they kicked the front door right on in. Yes, they did. But yeah, so we'll see. We'll see if Chris Brown, if they're going to ask for his alibi or whatever the case may be. He probably had one of his goons going and kick the boy door in.
Wow.
You don't think so? Or somebody taking sides was like, all right, I'm going to get this fool for you.
Man, I think they just played him weak. You know what I'm saying? They already putting him on that. They already putting him down to lose regardless. You know, so I think it's over with for him. You know what I'm saying? I mean, this fight is just a publicity for him now. But, if he loses, it's down goes Soulja Boy.
To the mat. That's not gonna be a good look. He's gonna be taking L's.
Come out with a new dance.
Okay, all right.
Come on, y'all, stop it. Let's not act like Soulja Boy is Grammy Award winning over there. Y'all like goes down.
Soulja Boy, watch him, man.
Soulja Boy.
He said, watch him.
Okay, but look, we're gonna get all the opinions about that because I was like, I want to see. You know, it's a bunch of boxers that's going in on social media now because they're like, dang, these fools are getting paid like this. You know, and we put our blood, sweat, and tears out there. We really do this. And they're hyping this up. You know, we should be getting the fanfare and things like
that.
They mad. You mad or not? But, yeah, they're mad. So I was just like, okay, so I wanted to get some opinions on some real folks. So next week we're going to have Jeff Mayweather is going to be on the show with us next week to give his opinion. And, oh, my goodness.
All right.
Wait till y'all hear it. He got hot on the phone. I had to shut him up and tell him, like, you know what? Say that for the show next week. And then we're also from Fight Hype. Fight Hype is a boxing platform, and only, you know, and typically when Floyd Mayweather does any type of release or any type of interview, he only does it with Fight Hype.
Oh, okay.
So we're going to have Percy on with us next week also from Fight Hype, along with a couple of surprise boxers. So it's going to be pretty fun to really kind of get their opinion, and we can kind of dive deep into the whole Soulja Boy Chris Brown thing, as well as a couple of the boxers have a couple of fights coming up. So we want to make sure that we promo the things that they have going on, too. So next week, y'all definitely have to listen in because, yeah, Jeff Mayweather going to be coming with some heat.
Yeah, yeah.
Jeff Mayweather next week.
Uncle Jeff. I was like, okay, and it's a PG show. I had to, like, let him know.
I was just about to say, you got to get the button ready for Uncle Jeff.
Yeah, because he was hotter than four fish greases on the phone. So, yeah, I was just like, okay.
Four fish greases.
Dang. Okay. Well, we will be right back with more Sound Off of Carla J. If y'all want to call in and talk to the homies, 832-230-5592, 832-230-5592. Give us a call. Hit us up.
Hey, it's Carla J. What's the latest?
Bring us in.
We are back. We are back in the place today.
In the place today.
With the sound off.
Put that little R&B sound in there.
Yeah.
Hey. With the sound off.
We are back. Okay, look, y'all.
80s and 90s don't go together.
Travesty or not. That's what it is. That's called a mashup. We mashed it up.
Yeah, we did that.
Thank you. Can I get some?
We did that.
All right. Okay, look. Travesty or not. It's a white guy playing Michael Jackson.
And what's wrong with that?
That's what I'm trying to get to. Okay, the first image of actor Joseph Fiennes came out. At first, a lot of people were talking about it. So we didn't know. And we didn't know, you know, for sure how it was going to come across or anything like that. Because they can do a lot of stuff with makeup.
Right.
And so the first images came out along with the short movie trailer. The movie is called Urban Myth. So it is kind of a comedy. It's kind of a spoof kind of movie.
Mm-hmm.
So it's, you know, has Liz Taylor in it. And then, Michael Jackson. And then the basis of their area of the movie is when 9/11 happened. And they all freaked out. And then it was they rented a car and drove to Ohio. So that's what it's pretty much covering. So it's just a big old spoof about that. But Paris Jackson, she is hot. She's hotter than five fish greases. Okay.
Five fish greases.
Because she said that it is an insult to her father's legacy as well as her godmother Liz Taylor's legacy. for them doing that. It's offensive, and it's, you know, a tarnish to their legacy.
Right.
Yeah. Yep, that's right. So I don't know. What do y'all think? You know, Michael Jackson super fans, they're asking for a boycott of the movie, which is, it's a comedic satire. So should they just take it like, you know, that's what comedians do?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's what they should do. I mean, everybody get picked at it every once in their life, you know. Some people just don't know. I mean, some people get sensitive to the situation.
Uh-huh. Okay. Well, we'll see. I know we have a caller on the line, Keith. I want to see what he wants to chime in and say. Keith, you're on the line with the sound off. What's up?
Yes, how you doing? My name is Keith, and I'd like to let you guys know I love you guys' show.
Thank you.
And I was just asking, what's his name? Showbiz? Why does he have glasses on?
Showcase. Yeah, well,
because
Bill.
I don't want nobody to see my eyes.
Oh,
because
his eyes are hypnotic. His eyes are hypnotic. Well, you can't stand it. You couldn't handle that, Keith.
Oh,
you don't want to.
Right. Okay.
Keith, you don't want
to. I'm like Cyclops.
So what is Dez doing? The Dez with two Z's. What is he doing? Is he looking down on his phone all the time?
Yeah. That's pretty much what I be doing for the most part. He
chime in when needed.
Yeah, you know.
Oh, that's pretty cool. But no, actually, I had a question for you, Carla G. You're talking about Blackish, and I was wondering about, do y'all really think President Trump is going to make it all the way through his term in 4 years?
First off, it's president-elect. I can't regard him as president just yet. We need to get past the inauguration. Let's see if that works, if that happens. But
that's only two more days.
Actually, no. It's a few more days. It's going to be the 20th, I believe. The 20th or 21st is the inauguration. So we got a few days to see what's going to happen, Keith. And then the other thing with that is, you know, I'm really, really hopeful, hoping and low-key praying that there's a impeachment, to be perfectly honest with you. I'm hoping. See,
you want him to get inaugurated and impeached in the same week?
No, I'm hoping that he doesn't make it to inauguration. Okay. I'm hoping that he doesn't make it to inauguration.
Obama?
Pardon me?
You don't give him the same chance that Obama had to make it?
To give him the same chance. You know what? It's one of those things that he's done a whole lot. And it's a whole huge separation in our nation right now. And I think that a lot of it is attributed to him, you know?
That's true.
And so that's what really ruffles my feathers in reference to him. So that's why I said, do I hope that something happens that and he's unable to make it to inauguration? Absolutely. But one of the things that with that too, there's a flip side to that is, you know, even if he does, he already has a lot of the cabinet in place. So a lot of his ideals are going to be implemented anyway,
right.
You know? So it's one of those things that
Are you going against Blackish? Blackish was saying the poor form and hoping to make it through. We all should come together as a nation.
You know, and if he does go, you know, and after the inauguration, then that's what we'll do. That's fine. I can give my opinion until I'm blue in the face, until, while he's president-elect. But once he is officially purple.
Like
okay,
showcase.
Purple in the face.
You can get blue like showcase glasses.
You know, blue like showcase glasses. But once he is president, absolutely. We won't have any choice but to give him
a...
I don't speak politics.
He's strictly R&B. Strictly R&B.
Because I don't have anything good to say right now, I say nothing.
All right.
So you stick with the chicks before sticks?
The chicks, extra sticks.
I enjoyed guys' show. Thanks very much. I was just calling in. Y'all have a good one.
Man.
All right,
appreciate it, brother.
All right, thanks. Okay, so, but yeah, I mean, speaking of that topic about...
I can't find the live feed on my phone like y'all got on y'all's.
Go to the KYND page. Go to KYND Radio, is streaming.
Ain't this it?
Scroll up, Dingleberry.
Dingleberry.
Bro, it took me about 20 minutes to get mine started.
Right there.
That ain't us.
Right there.
That ain't us.
Oh, give it to RJ.
Yeah,
he the genius. He the...
Yeah.
I don't know what's going on with your phone. Yeah, Dez's phone is a little crackish.
Give me the support over there.
Jesus, technical support. You are stupid.
Team Droid,
but
baby.
Yeah, with the whole thing with Donald Trump, and then let me put my little two cents in, because just yesterday there was a press conference that Donald Trump did. Okay, don't scroll to the right, but don't swipe right, man. No, Donald Trump did an ethics press conference, and then it was speaking about conflicts of interest and ethics. And my concern with that is, and you know, now people are questioning his ethics and the conflict of interest with his businesses. I'm like, ding dongs. And we said that on a previous show. They should have been thinking that about that before the election. Right. That's why his behind won the election, because he had a stronghold in everybody's dadgum business. You know what I mean? So that had a lot to do with it. That attributed a lot to it. So now you want to question ethics and conflict of interest? Come on now. Everything is so bass backwards with this, you know, whole election. It's ridiculous. So it was just a ploy, just a smoke and mirrors, more smoke and mirrors with Donald Trump. Right. So again, right now he's president-elect. I'm hoping that, you know, he does not become our president. We have a few days. We'll see what happens. Anything can happen, because the whole twist and turns with this, it's more twist and turns with the election than in this presidential race than it was with Soulja Boy and Chris Brown. You know, all the back and forth with that. So we'll see what happens. But if he does become our president officially, you know, then I'll support him. We'll see what happens. I mean, I'm not going to say I support him, but I will fall back so that we can see what it is the man is going to do. I will say that. We won't have any choice.
Stay tuned.
You know?
So is it true that that Donald Trump is really trying to get Mexico to pay for this wall?
He is trying to get Mexico to pay for it, but now he's saying that it's highly likely that we're going to have to pay for it, and then they're going to reimburse us.
When have they ever? Well, I'm going to keep that to myself.
I'm telling you, but yeah, if you don't have nothing nice to say, don't say nothing at all. But so that's what the deal is now. So we'll see what happens with that. I just think that it's a whole, you know, heap of mess. But again, you know, once he makes it past inauguration, we don't have any choice but to go with it and see what he's going to do, you know. And that's a scary thing, but we'll see. But I think for everybody that's feeling a little bit of anxiety, a little bit of angst about everything, watch the Black-ish episode. I mean, really watch that Black-ish episode, because it addresses a lot of our feelings. And I know I keep going back to it, but it was so epic. It was so well done. And it spoke to a lot of things that are being said publicly. It spoke to a lot of our feelings. And then it kind of summarized it at the end, you know. And then the summary was done with Martin Luther King, which was amazing. So that was great. But, yeah, so... thank you, Keith, for calling in and kind of getting that started and putting me on my little soapbox for a moment. I went on my rant. Thank you, Keith, for calling. But that was me. I had to put my two cents in, because that press conference was literally just yesterday. So, yeah, that was horrible. But the white guy playing Michael Jackson, y'all cool with that?
I'm cool with it.
Yeah.
Really?
You can do it.
Yeah.
And, but, you know, and after you think about it, if you really think about what black guy could have played him? You know what I mean? Like, what black guy really could have played him?
They've had some to try.
The only black guy the same color as Michael Jordan is Sammy Sosa. Sammy Sosa is the only one who bleached his skin.
But, oh, you know what? That is true, but the accent. So he wouldn't have been able to pull it off.
You don't think so?
Sammy Sosa has a really thick accent. I mean, it's triple thick. But yeah, he bleached his skin. He looks a hot mess. It's unfortunate too, because he was more attractive the way that he was previously. But that self love thing is a B.
I would have thought that Sammy Sosa was your brother for a minute.
Why? Shut up. He has a super, super thick accent. I know. Why is that? Why would you think Sammy Sosa
because
is my brother?
Y'all got curly hair. Y'all had the same color.
Oh.
When I had my little hair. We talk about when I had the curly hair, when you walked in and was like, for real.
Oh.
Remember when I did that?
The Rick James thing.
Yeah. Whatever.
Sammy
Sosa's sister. But yeah, so we'll see what happens. But again, it's a satire, comedic movie. You know, it's not really anybody black that we can name that would have been able to play Michael Jackson, you know, prior to his death. I don't think that it's offensive. I think that it's fun. And it's not even going to air here in the United States. It's airing in England first.
Wow.
Yeah. So it's like this big old uproar for no reason. But you guys, if y'all want to chime in, we are going to talk about black excellence next and talk about, you know, basically piggyback from a lot of the movies that are coming out, whether it's Fences or whether it's Hidden Treasures. Is that it? Hidden Treasures? I don't know.
Well, you sound like them people at the Golden Globes.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Hidden Fences. But you guys, y'all gotta give us a call, 832-230-5592. We'll be right back with Sound Off.
Steve Harvey Jr.
Hidden Figures, that's what it is. I sure did do it like the Golden Globes. Here we go. We back. Are you
about to come on in.
You chopping
the
scrolling?
Oh, nice. Hey. Oh,
nice. Nice feed it up.
No, I'm talking about. Yeah.
Okay. okay, DJ Michael Watt.
Yeah.
Up in here, up in the building. Chopping
already.
The scrolling. What? Already. Okay, we are back with the sound off, y'all. Okay, so we're going to talk about a couple of movies. Okay. I'm going to start giving my movie review next week. I'm going to start going in and really giving my opinion, getting on my soapbox.
Your soapbox?
Yeah, my soapbox. Because I recently saw Fences with Denzel Washington and Viola Davis, and I thought that movie was good. Again, I was crying. At the end, especially, because, you know, he has a brother. I don't want to give too much away. I just want to encourage people. It is still in theater, so if you haven't seen Fences, go and see it.
Is it about
I give
fences?
That two thumbs up. Yes, the fence is kind of a metaphor in the movie about just keeping the family in and keeping the family together.
Oh, okay.
You know? I heard it was like watching a fence.
It was not. It was not. It was good.
Jumping a fence. Jumping.
So what did you hear? What was your two cents that you heard about?
What I heard, it was like, yeah, it's good. Then it kind of puts you to sleep, and you wake up and catch a good part, and then, you know.
You know what? No.
Doze off again.
But what it was, see, you know, that's somebody, they got to get their mind right, okay? They got to get their mind right. Their mind wasn't ready for it.
Oh,
because
okay.
it was a part in the movie, and it was a bunch of different things that were going on. And then you were like, okay, what is this? What does this have to do with this? But you got to follow the story because it all comes together at the end like a gumbo.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Did they have a dog in it? They had a dog
like
in it.
A gumbo. Did she just say like
gumbo?
Because gumbo,
you know, gumbo has everything in it.
I don't know if I want to watch a movie like that.
It's good. And then at the end.
It comes together like a gumbo.
Yeah. It comes together like a gumbo. And then I'm gonna tell y'all this much. At the end, Denzel is no longer with us. A movie that killed off Denzel.
He ain't never died in no movie before.
Damn, she just killed the whole movie.
No, damn.
She just killed Denzel.
I didn't spoil the movie, though. Because even with me giving y'all that tidbit.
Well, now I know what happened.
No, but see, that's not what happened. Even with me giving y'all that tidbit, that's not even half of the half.
Well, what
the
happened?
Movie still goes
you
on
might
after that.
Well,
what happened?
See, even that's still a
well,
good
what happened?
Part. I'm not telling you. You got to go see it.
You already told us.
No, I didn't. You got to see
it. Did he get shot?
No, he did not get shot.
Did he jump outside the fence?
Bill probably got shot.
He jumped out the fence.
He always talking noise.
Did a cop tase him?
I am not. You are not getting it out of me. I'm not telling you how he died, but he is no longer with us during the movie.
He looked like he was old in that movie.
Towards the end of the movie, yeah.
So he's an old age dude, just passed away.
Nope.
He had high blood pressure.
So you gotta watch the movie. It was good because it still goes on even after that. Even given that bit of it, you still got to watch the movie because it was extremely powerful. And the way that it ended, it was like, it just kind of lets you know, and especially in the African-American community, how, especially our elders, mm-hmm. how close they are with, like, spiritually, and how it's like how they say, oh, I was speaking to the Lord, or I think all of us have a story or two where somebody mm-hmm. old in the family, you know, it was like, oh, they was waiting on Uncle Ben to get here, or mm-hmm. such and such was waiting on Auntie to get here, and yeah. then when she got here, and when she made it there, then they went on and let go. Or we have somebody old in our family that says, you know what, I'm just going to, you know, I'm ready to go. I'm tired. I'm done. Or whatever. All of us have those type of stories, and it shows
baby.
That spiritual connection.
Baby, God don't like ugly.
Yes.
They don't like ugly.
I'm telling you, it's that spiritual connection. So that's basically how the movie came together at the end, and it was like some different things that one
what movie is this?
Fences.
We still talking about Fences?
Yes.
You done told us Denzel
y'all
died.
Y'all gotta go and see it.
It's over now.
I'm telling you, you still gotta see it. Uh-huh. No, but okay, so look, y'all.
Catch him at the barbershop.
The other movie that we have to go and see. So everybody, go and see this movie. Everybody, go and see. You know what? See, you know what? Forget y'all. Y'all wrong. Y'all see how they do me? They do me just dirty.
Let's
do me wrong.
Let's go see Dr. Strange.
No, y'all. We're going to see Hidden Figures. We're going to see Hidden Figures. So everybody, y'all go see Hidden Figures so that we can talk about it next week. And we're going to talk about it in the latter part of the show. Because the early part of the show, we're going to have a number of boxers. We're going to have Jeff Mayweather on. And we're going to have Percy Crawford on from Fight Hype next week. So, So that's going to be fun. So they're going to be there throughout the show. So the latter part of the show, last segment of the show, we are going to have a movie review on Hidden Figures.
So Hidden Figures is about somebody hiding money.
So in other words, you're giving us a project.
Yes,
a homework.
I am giving y'all assignment. Figures. I'm giving y'all homework.
Right.
We're going to go together so we can tape it. So we can tape ourselves going in and then coming out. But we can't say anything until the show.
Can we take the movie?
No, you can't bootleg the movie while we're in there. Get us arrested. We'll be filming ourselves from jail. Be trapped up, okay?
Say we're going to film ourselves going in there.
Yep.
Might as well film
ourselves. No, we are not going to
tell us
ourselves.
Between the four of us, ain't nobody got a fire stick.
You know what? Actually, I do. Y'all come to
movie
the
night at Carla House.
$50. That fire stick
will come in tomorrow.
Pop that popcorn. But you got to go through a few until you get a good one that's a good quality. Okay, look, y'all. There is a young lady that is on Twitter. So those of you that are on Twitter that have Twitter accounts, Peaches
it's Diz White.
Shabazz. Her handle is WillFilm4Food. She compiled a number of important overlooked figures in the black community, and she just put them out today, and they started going viral. And I thought that that was pretty epic because there were a number of them that I hadn't even heard about. And the reason why I thought that this was pivotal or interesting is because I wanted to talk about the movie and talk about, you know, give that assignment so that we can go and see the movie Hidden Figures, which stars Taraji P. Henson.
Oh, Taraji's in it.
Yeah,
okay.
She's the star of the movie. And then she's like the black lady that basically did the mathematical genius that put all the calculations together so that the guys could make it to the moon.
Right.
Oh, that's Hidden Figures.
That's Hidden Figures. So that's what we have to go see. And those are the stories that you don't hear about that are really impactful and, you know, to our society and to our lives that we don't even know. A lot of inventions are by black people in society. So, you know, it's...
There's a black man that invented the ice cream scooper.
The ice cream? Sure.
So y'all didn't know that.
The stoplight, you know, the stoplight was invented by somebody black. Peanut butter, the pressing comb, Madam C.J. Walker. Thank you, Lord, for the pressing comb.
I don't even know why you're talking about it. Y'all done, that's a disgrace for the pressing comb and what y'all done start doing to y'all head
what
now.
What you mean? Oh, the all the weeds?
Yeah, y'all don't even need a pressing comb no more.
I used to get my hair pressed.
That lady
when
done
I was
put all
though.
That hard work in.
I used
right?
to get my hair pressed, and I'm glad I did because before, you know, I used to go to a little school that was kind of a mixed school or whatever, and then I used to see the girls, they would feather their hair.
Right.
Why I used to wet my hair, try to flip my nap. I thought I had feathers on it.
Hey, Carla, you ever had the forehead burn?
Have you seen Carla? Have you seen her forehead?
That was like a billboard.
How can you not burn that?
Okay,
burn.
So when I got my forehead burned, it was like extra, yes.
Oh wow.
So, but yes, I did go to Miss Carter. Rest in peace, Miss Carter. And I used to get my hair pressed. I grew up getting my hair pressed, baby.
Right on.
Yes. Okay. So you guys go and check out Will Film for Food, and her name is Peaches Shabazz. But
that's her Twitter account.
A lot of them. That's her Twitter account. Yeah. And then just as an example, she has like Ginger Howard. She's a golf prodigy, youngest black golfer to turn pro. Mm-hmm. Tony Hansberry II developed a suture method that decreases hospital stay and increases efficiency during operations for hysterectomies at the age of 14. All of these are African Americans that have done in really huge, impactful things at really, really young ages. So, you know, you guys go and check those out. Also, check out Hidden Figures. Yeah. Check us out next week where we're going to have Percy Crawford and Jeff Mayweather. Follow us.
Yeah, they need to follow
us. On our social media, the Sound Off with Carla J page. And then also follow Wild Bill at
Showcase 2000 Pro on Twitter.
All right.
Yeah.
G.I.?
At G.I. Jackson.
At G.I. Jackson on everything.
All day, every day.
On everything. And then also follow H-Town's page because y'all got a lot of stuff going up.
Oh, yeah,
going
definitely.
On, a lot
H-Town
of concerts.
H-Town for life, most definitely.
H-Town for life, and
H-Town
that's number four.
H-Town and Jodeci and Silk, you know.
H-Town, Jodeci and Silk, what y'all doing?
Yeah. It's about to go down.
About to go down. For real.
Oaktown.
Hey, this is a special
White
moment.
With two Z's.
Two Z's.
Yep. It's Dez White on Twitter. Dez White with two Z's.
All right. And are you Dez? It's Dez White on everything?
Nah, I'm just Dez White on everything, yeah.
On
I would have had Dez White just on Twitter, but one of my family members got it and told me that I had to pay for it to get it back from him.
Shady boots.
Yeah.
You see how family do that?
And the
shady.
Wild part about it is nobody in my family telling me who done it.
That's fact. So who are you going to make the payment out to?
I ain't making it out to nobody. That's why it's Dez White.
That is so crazy.
Yeah, like, go to Dez White on Twitter.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and look
I'm
at
gonna
it.
I'm going to go check it out. So they're talking about you got to pay for it, but so you don't know who you're going to pay?
Yeah, because they think this funny right now. They say I ain't made it yet. They gotta wait for me to get big.
Oh, that's shady. That's shady. But see, that's what I found.
That's my family.
That's
they think it's funny, though.
Okay. Right? But, okay, so I am
Carla J.
I am Carla J on Earthing.
Earthing.
Yeah.
Hey, who created marijuana?
Who created marijuana? We're not having that. You know what?
We can't have a discussion.
Who created
the
marijuana?
Indians. They were smoking on the peace pipe.
The peace pipe?
Thank you.
That was
the
marijuana?
Indians, yes.
That
and then that's when they would get paid and be like, oh, yo.
Really?
Hey!
This is how you get.
The engines.
Yeah.
Okay. But they say the hemp was in the Bible, though.
You know what? We got to go back. Okay, so we got to find that out. Y'all wrong for that. All right, y'all. Thank you so much for watching the Sound Off. We had a blast with y'all. Make sure y'all watch us next week. We have some amazing guests on. We're going to have some fun. Yeah. Jeff Mayweather going to go buck wild in the building. Love y'all.
Sound Off with Carla J. It's Carla J. What's the news?